45.
Shamima Begum, let's return to that story. The 19-year-old, the jihadi bride who wants to come home. Nikita Malik, director of the Centre on Radicalisation Terrorism at the Henry Jackson Society, wanted to get you on, and I know you have to dash, but I wanted to ask you a couple of things, Nikita, and thank you for making the time for us.
Sure.
What should the next 5 years hold for this girl and her child?
Well, I think the key question here is whether she's going to be brought back to the UK. And there's been a lot of confusion about this. Ben Wallace has said that he will not risk British troops' lives or British resources to bring her back. And this morning, Sajid Javid, the Home Secretary, said that he'd do whatever he could to prevent her from coming back, which is actually something that can be done using temporary exclusion orders. Now, there has been a lot of debate that she must be brought back and brought to justice in British courts. Now, if she is, then what the next 5 years will hold for her will essentially be a trial. And from the trial, a sentence. She'll have to serve time for the crimes that she's committed.
And be further radicalized.
Actually, I think that's a bit of a pessimistic view because, you know, in prisons, we have had not one or two, we've had hundreds of returnee fighters who are offered now. Previously, this was not the case under Channel, which was not mandatory. Now they're offered a desistance and disengagement program for returnees, which is it's a mandatory process. So one would hope that our counterterrorism strategy, which in my opinion is one of the best in the world, would be able to assist this woman. Ironically, this is the same strategy that's been criticized by many, many people in the population who are now appealing for this woman to be brought back so she can be put through this very same process. But nonetheless, we have this process for her. When it comes to the child is innocent, of course, has not voluntarily chosen to go to Islamic State like she did. So, of course, the child would need to be put in care or would need to be put with a relative or someone who is capable of looking after this child. But I think the key question here is whether she will be brought back or not, the kind of process she'll go through, because that will set a precedent for many other British men and women who want to come back to the UK because there is now no caliphate that they are part of anymore.
We spoke to Rukmini Kalimaki, the New York Times journalist, who does the wonderful, interesting and fascinating podcast on ISIS. Not many people know more about ISIS than her. And she said, and it was interesting, she said it's actually sexist to say that this girl is a victim. She said, for sure, these women have agency.
Of course. I mean, Rukmini's work in this is unparalleled. I myself have done some research on this subject. And when you look at the cases in courts, in fact, it's the opposite of what most people think. They think, you know, the word grooming has been bandied, you know, put about quite a bit. But these girls have, you know, in these court cases, actively sought out information, done independent research, done it of their own free will. And the boys are actually the ones who tend to travel with their families or are kind of duped into doing it. So in some ways, the fact that she is a girl, many people are saying she was a child when she went, she's pregnant. These are all vulnerabilities that people are using to paint her as a victim. But they're the very same vulnerabilities that are used by ISIS when they are trying to impregnate women to create the next generation of fighters. These women serve a crucial role in bolstering the movement, marrying fighters, bolstering these fighters, and distributing propaganda. So the to say that they are in any way, you know, not doing what a man, not making the same decision that a man would make when they join this movement is unfair. And if I may, it's also unfair to the real victims of ISIS, who are the Yazidi women, who are the Christian women who were abducted and raped and made into sex slaves. They are the victims, the thousands of them. Not this woman. She's not a victim. She has chosen to go there of her own free will. And I think painting it in any other way is absolutely incorrect. She hasn't shown any remorse. We need to keep that in mind as well through the interview that we listened to. There's no regret and no remorse in what she said. And so she doesn't even, show that she's upset about what she's done.
What she's seen. Thank you. I know you've got to go dash and get a flight. Mm-hmm. Thank you for coming on this morning. Nikita
Thank
Malik.
Thank you.
Director
My pleasure. All right.
Bye. Director of the Centre of Radicalisation and Terrorism at the Henry Jackson Society.